Hi lovelies, it's me Sherry with Live Love Latte, and thanks for joining me for this organization video. September is National Disaster Preparedness Month in the US, so I thought this would be a perfect time to show you a video of how I've started prepping for my family of four. This is an emergency binder that I put together from a $10 printables kit from a bowlfulloflemons.net. I'll put any resources that I think would be helpful to people like me who are new preppers, who are mom preppers, in the description box below. YouTube has a great community of prepper channels like Urban Prepper, Zombie Tactics, Captain Burrs. I'll put links to their channels. It was actually the Urban Prepper who really encouraged me to prep for my family. About a year ago, I made a comment on one of his videos and I said something like, "Oh, I really love your channel. I'm an unofficial prepper." And then he replied back asking, "Why are you an unofficial one versus an official prepper?" With that question, I realized I was wanting everything to be perfect before I considered myself a prepper. But as with most things in life, if not all, things cannot be perfect. We've got to start somewhere. And so with that, I just decided I'm going to start prepping. I'm going to learn. I'm going to gather information, watch these videos, talk to different people. FEMA suggests that we are prepared for at least 72 hours, if not up to 2 weeks. So I'm going to show you today my 72-hour emergency food kit. This bin can either be for shelter in, staying at home, or if we have to drive away, we can stick it in our trunk. I put this together with the idea that there would be no electricity, especially we have an electric stove, and what would I be able to serve my family if we had to either shelter in or drive away. National disasters happen all the time, like earthquakes, tornadoes, storms, hurricanes, and it's actually the 10-year anniversary of Hurricane Katrina, and as many of us know, it was days before many of them got help. So I know there's things that we can never prepare for, but if we could do at least some preparation, I think it's worth our while. In the inside of the bin, I have this inventory sheet that is part of the emergency binder printables. I have it in a sheet protector and it's labeled page 1 of 2. The other side is page 2 of 2. And I've just broken it down into breakfast, lunch, dinner. And on the other side, I have snacks and sweets. So I put down the name of the item, the quantity, and the expiration date. And the suggestion is to check this every 6 months. So the best time is to check it every daylight savings time. I move anything that is expiring into the pantry so that we can consume that. And if I have to replace any items, I do it at that time. I've written it in pencil so that it's easier to change the name of the food item or the quantity or the expiration date. I think an inventory sheet is perfect because you can see at a glance whatever is in the bin and you can see at a glance what is expiring. I have a Ziploc full of paper plates, forks, spoons, and knives, and napkins worth for 4 people eating 3 times a day. I put all of the canned goods at the bottom just because of the weight, and I tried to get canned goods that had a top like this, although I do have a can opener here that is from the Dollar Tree. I think if you can get canned goods with this kind of opener is better because it's just one less thing that you have to rely on. I pack things in here that if I were to have no electricity or stove, they would be ready to eat. I did put mac and cheese in here, although it's more of a luxury item because you don't want to use too much water when water is scarce. Just like mac and cheese, preppers recommend ramen noodles, and you know ramen also takes water. So again, it's just a matter of the situation. If there's enough water, then definitely you can make stuff like this. And sometimes you need items like this where, you know, if there's a disaster, there's a lot of stress and anxiety, it is nice to have some comfort food. With preparation, you can definitely put sweets and treats like this, or if you are gluten-free, vegan, etc., it's just a matter of putting all those things into this bin. Comfort doesn't always have to come in the form of food. We do have a comfort kit that would include items like a favorite book, crossword puzzles, a favorite blanket or stuffed animal for kids. And then lastly, I have a shoebox here where I've corralled most of the snacks. You can see there's beef jerky, granola bars, mandarin oranges, some pudding there, organic protein granola, and some raisins. and then I tried to pack it so that the label is facing out. I hope you enjoyed this video of my 72-hour emergency food kit. Please leave a comment below and let me know if you have any questions or any comments, what you would add to this bin, and I will see you next time. Bye!
Please subscribe to my channel, Live Love Latte, and join me on my daily adventures as a mompreneur.